what I am optimistic about that as we go forward, now this model will evolve. I doubt we will have a pan-India logistics player who will be able to reach out to all the towns. But we want to see models where there will be local and regional players having tie-ups with multiple players in other regions, and coming together they can provide probably a pan-India or a international linkages. The challenge there is, for example, we've been talking to some of the Apple players. If Apple have to go from Delhi to Mumbai or to Chennai, the truck goes full. But if it comes back empty or even half empty, you don't make money. So there has to be, a full capacity utilization to the market and the back. So that's why it is a capex intensive industry. I think it's going to take time. And I am hopeful if organized food retail can come up, there will be many players who can come into the market and help entrepreneurs. So yeah, for the time being, I would say it's an issue.
The typical problem we face, today I'm sitting here, but 1996 we started contract potato farming. The first year we farmed five acres, got a very good result. The next year we farmed 100 acres at my own farm. And I couldn't harvest it because the cost of harvesting was more than the cost of selling it. The realization which I was getting. And I had to leave the crop inside. That is the time when six of us came together. We started aggregating our produce. And since that day, we have not turned around. Nearly 6,000 farmers have joined us. We've started working on the post-harvest side. We've started working on the applied research side. We've started working. But believe me, we got support from every end. We have not taken a single penny in terms of any kind of subsidies from the government. But yes, in terms of support, in terms of knowledge-based support, yeah, people who are forthcoming and helping you out in terms of government. The only thing is initiative is required. The initiative comes in because it makes economic sense now. 10 years back, it was not making that kind of an economic sense. Now it is making economic sense. You can find every region you will find there is a local player who is growing. The consolidators are growing. They are moving backwards. Like we say that the consolidator or the mandi player is just a commission agent. The pressures have started coming on them also that they have to work backwards. Anybody who will not work backwards next 5 years will lose his footfall of the farmer coming. Now this is the trend which is emerging. Which at the grassroots level, once you start doing that surveys in the APMCs, you'll start feeling it. So this is a fact which actually is where aggregation has started now mobilizing in terms of people in a non-conventional way they have started coming together. That is where this business potential is coming in. Yes, I don't know the models that will come in terms of how they'll grow, but yes, definitely that movement has started.
Just to finish your question on the mangoes and the bananas. So for me, it's a pure question of resources. I do one product, I do it really good, and the whole potential, now we're bringing all the export knowledge to India itself. India is the largest market for bananas in the world. It's the only market left on this planet where you don't have a branded banana across the company. We've ramped up for exports a system where we have a planability that I can tell you exactly which product is coming out of which pack house, in which quantity, in which date in the next weeks. And this gives you consistency in quality and volume, which I will use in India now. So this is a model, once this works, and I love Indian mangoes, best in the world, but I focus purely on banana at the moment.
Hello.
Thank you, sir. In fact, I am a banker basically, but involving in the social sector from last 12 years. Small and marginal farmers, it is a way of life to them only. Whatever you see the progress which we are doing, the result is not up to mark. Reason being that basic needs for the farmer is the water and technology. If you can provide the water technology, then the things can be developed. But without water and without technology, nothing can be. We are working with the tribal population. and we have tried with the watershed program, along with the technology, along with the government, that is known as Jivika project. All resources are provided and multiple income has increased. So this type of thing, and what you are talking about banana and all these perishable goods, they require a proper storage facility. I may tell you my, you see the practical example, when I was controlling head in the bank, we promoted the strawberry cultivation, having the price from 300 to 400 per you see kilo. Everybody was attracted. All these grape gardens in Nasik, the you see area, converted to the strawberry. And when strawberry produced by increase, the prices came down to 18 rupees. Look here, because there is no storage keeping capacity. So before, just like you see the tomato, the you see potato, very difficult. So my submission to you, that composite package practices has to be provided if we want to promote this farming population. We, you see, provide this relief to this 85% population. That is my section. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your suggestion.
No problem. The thing is about it come to lychee, mango and all that we always find missing, and it's always challenging whenever we do interaction with farmers or vendors. One element that is missing is investment in terms of mind, intellectual capacity of farmers, and whosoever have got intellectual capacity are not ready to come. How this forum investor, especially VC and investors, are going to work on it. Some organization is working on just motivating young mind to come back and start doing farming. Here a lot of change will come. So how something is going on this way?
We take that on board. I think we can spend the next day discussing this. But
I just want to say that the fact that so many people have converged here and Sankalp delegate list keeps going up year on year, and so the entry into social enterprise, I think that's very optimistic. More investors, more people in the ecosystem, more media writing about these issues, not just agriculture, but I'm talking about generally about social enterprise, business as a solution to impacting lives. I think it's very encouraging, and I think we should be very optimistic that more and more people will come in. But I just want to end by saying that one of the things that I've heard people saying is, if you want to become a mechanical engineer, you actually study mechanical engineering. If you want to do agriculture, you actually do study agriculture. But if you want to be a social enterprise, what do you go and study and do it? Because you haven't done your MBA, you haven't done a social work course. It's a kind of a KHD. What is that KHD? Can you teach about it? Is what I'm hearing people say. So I think one way is looking at talent, but I think educated talent, if it needs to come, people need to take an informed choice in their careers. And I think there's a lot of education that has to be done at the student level to catch them young to come into the sector. So that's just a quick response I wanted to make. Thank you.
Great. I think on that positive note, and also the positive note that Mr. Rudra Pratap Singh started with, that the return for the farmer is improving, and especially in the irrigated, in the non-irrigated, less so, that augurs well, because this industry will only grow if the bottom of the pyramid gets a better return for being in this space, and that's what is happening, and so that therefore that augurs well. But clearly a lot of business models yet to be proven and to be developed, and with that, from my side and from all of us, just to say thank you.
Thank you, panelists. You have dispelled all our doubts about the profitability of agriculture and rural businesses. May I now call upon Rashmi to hand over mementos to our organizers, the panelists.
Very fast.